Annyeonghaseyo, Changwon, South Korea, home for the next 8 days to the second stage of the ISSF World Cup 2018. It's the eighth time the city has hosted a World Cup stage in the last 15 years, and 876 athletes representing 70 national Olympic committees will compete in 15 finals. I'm Rory McAllister, and along with Jamie Stangroom, let's have a look at what happened. Day one and the first final, Mr. Vasquez Rania in attendance, who will retire as president of the ISSF at the end of the year. Isván Pényi of Hungary, who won a gold in Guadalajara last month. Again, he's on the hunt for another medal. It's the two Russian athletes who stand in his way.
For the next competition, Sharp
Low. Ivik Hisny Orosi Pényi's coach looks on.
Down.
It was gold in Guadalajara, but this time it's a bronze for Isván Pényi. It's Russia versus Russia now. Dryagin trying to hold his nerve. And does so with a decent 10.5. Franz Schreiber, the Secretary General, seems impressed. Both score a 10.1, which means Dryagin takes the gold. Vladimir Lisin, Vice President of the ISSF, shakes the hand of Oligario Vasquez and Franz Schreiber. Not only does Dryagin take the gold, he's also the new world record holder of 251.2, eclipsing the previous record by 0.2. Rifle shooters of the future, who knows? Jenny Stenner of Norway, currently in the bronze medal position. She's only 0.2 behind Lin of Chinese Taipei. Meanwhile, Zhao Ruji maintains her lead with an impressive 10.7 shot at this stage. It's a bronze for Norway. Jenny Stenner waves to the crowd. Shouts and applause ring out from the audience here in Changwon. Lin of Chinese Taipei now versus Zhao of the People's Republic of China with a difference of 1.0. The Chinese athletes just really are so composed, experts in rifle shooting. There's Du Li, an impressive career in her own right in shooting. And it's a 10.7 from Zhao Ruji and a 10.3 from Lin Yingxin. Means the People's Republic of China have a gold medal. Zhao, who's only 19 years of age, has set a new world record of 252.4. First final of day two, and it's the 25 meter pistol women. Here's Lin of China, who leads at the moment. Will it be a gold medal for China today? Not if Galiabovich of Australia has anything to say about it. The battle for the medals continues. Galiabovich has been sandwiched between the two Chinese athletes, and it's another medal for China. This time it's bronze for Yao Yuxi. It goes to a shoot-off for gold and silver, 34 each, and an exciting finale to this final. That's a great camera angle, isn't it? Really gives you an idea of what the shooters are aiming at. This is purely a test of nerve. Now you've come this far. Who has the composure to hang on in there? And it's gold for Galiabovich. She's delighted, as is her father. How on earth did she deal with two shoot-offs?
It didn't add pressure, but I just needed to motivate myself to keep going because I was getting a bit tired by the stage of the final already. So it was in my head just more like, keep going, you're strong, you can do this, that sort of thing.
This is the second final of day two, and the Republic of Korea are on for a medal. And it's the first medal for the Republic of Korea for this World Cup. Kim Jae-hong and Song Soo-jo have the bronze in the 10-meter air rifle mixed team final, and everyone's loving it. It's Russia versus China now for the gold. Vidovina and Maslenikov shoot again. Du Li, the Chinese coach, overseeing her shooters, Yang Horan and Zhao Ruji. Number one says Hu Xicheng, and he's right because it's another gold medal for China. They make it look so easy. Russia get the silver, and they don't look too disappointed.
It's a wet and windy Changwon International Shooting Range today, and away from the comfort of an umbrella is Alessandra Perilli of San Marino, looking to avoid elimination from the competition, currently on 24 hits. And she hits that one, so make it 25. Fatima Gavez now with a two-hit lead at the top. Oh, and that's a miss by the shooter from Spain in the rain. Here's Perilli. And she fails to take the chance to close the gap. And it's another miss for Galvez. Could this prove to be costly for the Spaniard? Her problems continue as Alberto Fernandez watches on. Perilli will need to get this to have any chance of staying in. And she misses. So Alessandra Perilli leaves the competition with the bronze medal, and she seems pretty pleased with that achievement, finishing on a total of 27 hits. A great round for Satu Mekelä-Nummela sees the Finn rise to the top of the table, one hit ahead of Galvez with five targets remaining. Fatima Galvez goes again now. And it's a miss. She really needed to get that one. Mekelä-Nummela here. No problem for the Finn. Her coach with a cautiously optimistic nod. He knows this is within touching distance. A miss for Galvez. And it's a chance for the Finnish shooter to clinch the gold medal now. And she does it. Stefa Čukova of Slovakia shows her appreciation as the gold and silver medalists share a moment together.
First final of day three here with Matsuda, the 2017 Shooter of the Year, looking on. Artem Chernosov of Russia leading at this stage as the medals are decided. Shazar Richley of India, who won the gold at Guadalajara last month, is also in contention for another medal. Samuel Donkov of Bulgaria, who is a carpenter when he isn't competing as a shooter. Artem Chernosov, who's been ice cool throughout this final so far and has led since the sixth shot of this final. And it's a bronze medal for Bulgaria, their first of this World Cup. Donkov supporters are delighted, and rightly so. It's Chernosov who leads. Ritzvi is 0.4 behind. Can he make it another gold to match his achievements in Guadalajara? Just look at Chernosov, ice cool. Nothing seems to faze him. And 9.9 from Ritzvi, which means he's closing the gap. It's 0.2 between the two shooters now. This is business. And it's a 10 for both. The gold goes to Russia. Chernosov, the coolest man in town, turns as if it was just routine, all in a day's work. Acknowledges the crowd. Ritzvi is congratulated, but he'll have to settle for silver, this time here in Changwon.
The Changwon rain stopped in time for the men's trap final, as Yuri Liptak of the Czech Republic looks to build on his one-hit lead at the top of the table. Another hit like that will help the Czech shooter remain the man to catch. Here comes Yavuz Ilnam of Turkey, currently in third spot. It's a great hit for the big Turk, but it's out of his hands. And now Mauro De Felipes. And it's a hit for the Italian, taking him on to 36 and consigning Ilnam to third place. So the shooter from Turkey will take the bronze medal home with him from Changwon. He accepts the audience applause. Liptak still leads De Felipes by just a one hit with 10 targets to go. Here's the Czech shooter. Oh, and he stays on 37 hits for now. There you have the two coaches concentrating hard in Changwon. Oh, and it's another miss for Liptak. The Czech coach knows he has his work cut out now. Here's De Felipes, two hits ahead. Another hit for the Italian. He's so close now and his coach surely knows it. Yuri Liptak really needs this with just five targets left. He misses. So it's De Felipes now to seal the gold. Oh. And he does it, finishing on 45 hits. There's his wife and emotional Jessica Rossi as the gold medal winner from Italy embraces his coach. And it's silver for Yuri Liptak of the Czech Republic. Oh, and it looks like there'll be love in the Changwon air tonight.
First final of day four with Ji Xiaojing of China leading. Zorana Arunovic of Serbia. A bit of a character when she's away from the shooting range. Composes herself. And it's a 10.4 and the bronze medal. Raises her arms, even bows and acknowledges the camera. That's pure class. It's Ji of China now versus Chaika of Belarus. 9.9. Wow, 10.8, and the crowd are ecstatic. A dramatic finale to this final. So here we go, final shot. Chaika scores a 10.1. Is it enough? And a 9.4 from G, which means it's indeed enough. And Chaika wins the gold medal on the final shot. Drama, literal drama here in the finals hall at the International Shooting Range here in Changwon. She already has three World Cup ISSF gold medals to her name. And there's number four. My favourites now, the 25-metre rapid-fire pistol men's final featuring the bronze medalist from Guadalajara last month, Christian Reitz of Germany. Here's his countryman, Oliver Geis, who won a silver here in Changwon 3 years ago. That means it's a bronze for Geis. He's delighted. A fist punch to celebrate. It leaves Christian Reitz now in the hunt for gold, but it's a tall order. He's 3 points behind Kim Jong-hong of the Republic of Korea, who's on for a world record so far. Five hits, wow, and for the fifth time in a row, the roar from the crowd proves that it's good. Reitz now to shoot for pride. Four hits, but it's anecdotal. Kim, the 2014 world champion, sets a new world record of 38. He only missed twice during the whole final, and to do that in front of your home crowd, that's exceptional.
Not everybody was gripped by the trap mix team event. That's better. So it's the team from Kuwait with the better bib number looking to make it count by catching the leaders to survive elimination. Oh, and Sarah Afarel misses that one. Oh. And it's a miss by Penny Smith of Australia. They're not safe yet. Another hit for Slovakia. They're sitting pretty at the top of the table for now. And finishing on 29 hits, the bronze medal goes to Khaled Amultaf and Sarah Alawel of Kuwait. With five targets remaining now, Slovakia have a two-hit lead over the team from Australia. Little fist pump there as Penny Smith steps up. Ready? It's a miss for the Aussie shooter. Another miss for Penny Smith. Surely that makes it mission impossible now for Australia. Stefa Chakova steps up with a chance to secure the gold medal. She hits that one. It's 40 hits for Slovakia. A delighted looking coach and teammate there. Signing out on 41 hits, Eric Varga and Susanna Rehak. Stefa Chakova of Slovakia take the gold medal, while silver goes to Jack Wallace and Penny Smith of Australia.
Day five and a grueling final, a real test of nerve, concentration and skill. Sergei Kamensky of Russia, who has led from the start, finds time to smile down at the camera as he prepares to switch from prone to standing for the final stages of the competition. Isvan Paney, who bagged bronze a few days ago in the 10-metre air rifle final. And it's the same colour for Paney. He's still only 21 years old. What a future he has ahead of him. Kamensky, the unlucky silver medalist from the last games, still leading. It's Russia versus Italy now. Stop. 10.4 for De Nicolo. And a 10.0 from Kamensky. It's enough to secure the gold medal. Gary Anderson, vice president of the ISSF, who's been at every final so far this week, congratulates. Kamensky raises his rifle, whilst the five-time Olympian Marco De Nicolo has to settle for the silver medal. Second final of day five, and there's a difference of 5 points between Serbia and China. Germany are 0.7 behind the Chinese team. Arunovic, who already picked up a medal this week, a bronze in the 10-metre air pistol final. Shoots a 10.7. And with a 10.0, it'll be another bronze medal for Serbia. Goran Mikec, Damir's brother, looks very proud. So it's down to the gold and silver, and Germany consisting of married couple Christian and Sandra Wright are now 4 points off the leaders. Ji and Wu of China are on for a world record if they keep this up. Sandra Wright with an 8.8, some oohs from the crowd. Christian Wright's keeping up the pressure with a 10.8. And a 10.4 from Zhao Zhujing means it's a new world record and another gold medal for China. Sandra Wright scores a 9.7 and the Germans finish 3.5 behind the Chinese and have a silver medal, both of them. Day six, and it's the only final of the day. It's been led so far all the way by Franziska Pehr of Austria, who was fourth in the final in Guadalajara last month and just missed out on a medal. Moving now to the standing position after 15 shots in the prone position. It's Wang Nao of China who leads with a difference of 1.9. Some very enthusiastic support for Lee, for the Republic of Korea. They've even written signs with English translation. So cute, lovely. Ziva Dorsvak with a 10.1 shot, which means a medal is secured, and it's bronze for the Slovenian athlete. Loud applause from the crowd, and it's nice to see. It's neck and neck between a pair of Austria and Wang of China. They're both tied on 448.4. 9.8 from pair. And a 9.9 from Wang. She's won the gold by 0.1. That's an eighth of a millimetre in terms of accuracy. Incredible. Amazing that this final should literally go down to the final shot. What a finish.
time for the women of the Changwon World Cup to get their skeet on. The world number one Kimberly Rhodey is the shooter to catch, her closest rival being Amber Hill of Great Britain, 2 hits behind. A hit and a miss there for the Brit. That's going to make this chase even harder for her. Here is Kimberly Rhodey at station 3. Taking the pair, she's now onto 44. She's only missed 2 all final. Amber English now consigned to 3rd place. She hits the pair, signing out on 44 hits with the bronze medal to her name and a high five from coach Todd Graves and brother James. 3 is the difference now between Rhodey and Hill going into the final 10 targets. Another 2 hits for Amber Hill, but with Rhodey just not missing at the moment, it looks like she'll have to settle for the silver. And Hill takes her final pair at station 5 to applause from her coach and team. Rhodey now, just 2 to seal gold and to match her world record. Can she beat it? She's matched it and secured the gold. Will there be a new world record as well? Smashed it with a new world record of 58 hits. Kimberly Rhodey clinches the gold medal here in Changwon. Is there any stopping her? The Ambers taking silver and bronze. The sun was shining for the final day of competition, with Vincent Hancock leading the way, 3 targets ahead of Rossetti.
4.
2 hits. He's just unstoppable. Rossetti now.
4.
Chasing Hancock. Oh, and a miss. That's not good news for the Italian, especially with the way Hancock's going at the moment. Here's Aramburu of Spain, currently in the bronze medal position. A hit and a miss, so it will be the bronze medal for Juan Jose Aramburu of Spain. That's his 4th World Cup bronze. Hancock's lead is now 4 targets and he's heading towards equaling that world record of 59 hits. There's 2 more. On to 57 for the American shooter. 2 more hits. He's equaled that world record for the 2nd time in 1 month. Coach Todd Graves punches the air. And it's Gabriele Rossetti shooting for pride now. 2 hits for the Italian. He's on to 53. And the Olympic champion goes again. 2 more hits. Mutual appreciation from the 2 athletes. And we asked Vincent Hancock how he adapted to the conditions here in Changwon.
The final targets were beautiful. The visibility was great. We had changed lenses a couple different times. We had some clouds coming through, so just trying to make some small adjustments. But thankfully, it's a good practice. A good practice match for World Championships when it really matters.
So with 45 medals now handed out, that's all from us here in Changwon. Next up on the ISSF World Cup Series 2018 is Rifle and Pistol at Fort Benning, USA. But for now, from all of us at ISSF TV, we bid you farewell from South Korea. 감사합니다.